Howdy, folks, and welcome once more to Let's Stick Around and Escape from Tarkov. Today, once more on the Lighthouse, we're probably going to be here a lot. I did pick us up a rifle. We have ye olde 10-round SKS with the weird magazine and all that fun stuff. I was going to get a sight on it. Hey, frame rate. I assume that's it spawning bots. I was going to get a sight for this thing, but you have to buy them on the auction house. And I found out that at some point they changed it, so now to use the auction house we have to be level 15. So we're actually not high enough level to use the auction house anymore. Which kind of fucking sucks, but okay. As per protocol, no idea where we are, although that this road is so curved. I believe we are probably in like the northeast side of the map, perhaps? If I had to guess. Because, is there a campsite right here? Yes, okay, so we're in like the east side of the map. Okay, alright. Apparently, there's goodies around here. But I figure there's probably also bot spawns. Sadly, like, there are no maps that are just like a map of the zone. I want just like a map of the zone and show me where the exits are. But like, all the maps, because, you know, most of the people that play this in multiplayer, you know, you're gonna have to try hard because it's a competitive game. Like, they want guides, so the maps show, like, where everything is, so, like, I know where all the secrets are and shit on this, and that's kinda less fun. Let's poke around a little bit. Like I said last time, I did, tinker with the spawning of items just laying out in the world, and when the map generated, I saw that there were, like, 300, like, random things in the world that is not container loot. So there should be goodies around. It's probably going to take us a little while to figure out like what a good number is for item spawns. Like I'm looking more for what feels good than what's necessary realistic to like the live servers. So we'll dink with it. I'm not worried. We're currently at 1.5 times. If we need to go higher, we will. That's a grenade. Ooh, that's a lot of grenades. Holy shit. Yeah, Arcurus told me they added some new grenades. Offensive hand grenades. Ooh, this is an impact grenade. Those are good. Also impact grenades. So what's the difference between an offensive and a defensive impact grenade? Okay, so the RGN is more damage, but in a tighter radius and with less lachetes by the look of things. Okay, so when I hit the G key to lob a grenade, I'm not gonna know which one I'm throwing though, will I? That's not fun. Fucking sight on this thing is so bad. Oh my god. It was either this or the Mosin, and I love the Mosin, but this was cheaper and I'm kinda a little low on funds, and I don't want to just have, like, oh wow, just invisible walls here? Really? Kinda shit, guys. Alright, well, let's see what's over here. Arcurus did tell me that there is a new faction that they added on this map called, it's written on here, I think, like, Rogues? And apparently they have, like, a water facility that they guard, and they won't attack us unless we start shit, basically. And he warned me that they had mounted weapons, which really worries me. Because, like, there's one map in this game, I think, that has, like, mounted machine guns on it. So I don't want to deal with that. Okay. So you see, because of the map, I know. Get back this way. Let's see, where would it be? Like around here somewhere? Maybe. There's a hidden stash back here. Somewhere. Oh, they made walking through trees quieter. I'm curious. Oh, there it is. Curious when that happened. Any goodies? So, thing, Other thing. Oh, that's a guitar pick. Yeah, we're gonna take that. Tape, and I think flash drives are valuable. I mean, we're gonna take it all, but just kind of deciding what goes into the goodie kit. Alright, let's poke around. Oh yay, rain. Because, I mean, we never get that. Fucking locked again. I'm curious. All locked, shit. All of them? Wait, you can't even open it on this side. Okay, yeah, so this is gonna... Yeah, shit, fuck! Oh. I was just gonna say, this is gonna be closer quarters. Ah, shit. Sound effects you don't want to hear! Gunfires and reloads. Jeez, man. Alright, yeah, we're bleeding like crazy here. Use bandage. We don't have a good bandage on us, do we? Like one of the mega ones. Oh, is this the end of Zombie Shakespeare? How are we looking? Heavy bleeding. Medic. We should just put a splint on our head. Yeah, we are, as per protocol, in really bad shape. I suppose I can stop the bleeding with tape? No. I was just, like, as we were walking up here, I was like, yeah, this is gonna be, like, close quarters combat, so I should switch over to my handgun. Hey, buddy. You fucked me up pretty good. Got any medic on you by any chance? You do! Just stop heavy bleeding. Bullet wounds and other serious injuries. Why, yes! Please. Please to be stopping the doom bleed. And if it does... I can't remember if this just, like, heals our limbs so we can use it again. I think that might be what this does. It would be nice. Ah, oh, I was gonna say it would be nice. We can also fix that bleeding. Upside, though, is we have a good med kit now. Slicker's bar and some smokes. And we're gonna take this, and we're gonna take this. Really good, rig on this dude. Actually, not as good as ours. Or not better than ours, I would say. Probably equivalent. Oh, we gonna die. We're gonna bleed to death. Let's just poke around here. Man! Computer. I gotta get used to being a sneaky motherfucker and approaching these places carefully as opposed to just kind of rushing in. Oh, vision fading. We just lost our head. That's great. How are we looking? 79 health, and it's negative 54. Just, like, throw myself off a building or something at this point. Yeah. Here. End it! Lay on the grenade! Yup. We did kill him. Hand cannon doing work. 9,000 worth of healing. Oh, and we lost all of our water and shit because we got gut shot, of course. Damn it. I should have drank a bunch of stuff and eaten what I had on me before I blew myself up. That would have been smart, though. Okay. So we do have this, which I'm actually going to hold on to. Let's go ahead and heal up. I shouldn't say heal, but like eat and drink. Bring this. Bring this. Bring this. Bring not that. Esmark, I should have brought one of these fucking things with me. If I had, we would have survived. But I didn't. That's how this works. I suppose you can... Okay, yeah, you can't use healing from... You can't use anything from your backpack. Good to know. Alright. Hand cannon. Ammo. That's it. Alright. PMC, it looks like we got a scab with a shotgun and words are hard. Raincoat. There we go. I got there. Just took a minute. And we're just gonna go right back in. We lost our helmet, we lost our armor, and we lost our fancy glasses. So we're gonna be going a little squishier this time. And we are underarmed. Not that our rifle really did us anything last time, because it's, I think those rifles are really, the SKS is only good at long range. Because like their sights are just not good enough for close quarters. And I mean, really, you'd want something automatic anyways, preferably. I will say, when we were in the factory last time, we picked up that, what was it, like an MP5 or something. And that thing wrecked face, so I don't know. I don't know if they've necessarily buffed, like, damage by ammo types, or changed how armor works, or maybe just have scavs with less gear on them. Because that dude that we killed, I think it said I shot him in the thorax, and that's what killed him. So, you know, that was, you know, center of mass fire. And, hey, if it was enough, I will happily take that. Alright. So, oh, it's earlier than I thought it was. Shit. Alright. Well, we're on a road. I assume that this is, like, there's a main, like, a big main road that goes through this entire area. I assume that this is maybe that? I don't know. It's goodies. No, just random crap. I'm sure there can probably be stuff here, there's just not... So we are at a marked disadvantage here because it's dark, because the AI in this has night vision, essentially. So that kind of sucks. But, you know, we'll make do. The first thing we need to do is actually figure out where we are. And from there we can... figure out where Xville will be. You guys got any of them there flashlights? No? No. Okay, thought I'd ask. God, I saw those lights over there and like I just immediately had a flashback to like Arma playing at night and seeing like enemy vehicles light cresting the hills and stuff. Take, unknown item, sure. What did we just loot? Wire? Sprats. Delicacy Sprats from the Alkanafter Company. Interesting. I have no idea what a Sprat is. Looks like maybe... I mean, it's food of some sort, obviously. Maybe meat, fish. Fish, perhaps? I'm not seeing an expiration date, so it's probably good. Man. I haven't had, like, canned sardines in ages. I used to love those when I was growing up. Have them on, like, sandwiches. With, like, the hot mustard. Oh my god. Man. Childhood. Good shit. What the hell? Like, yeah, I have no idea where we are. I think I might know where we are. I think we're in, like, the center of the map. Is there, like... a bunch of what? I think we're in, like, the center of the map. I'm fairly certain we're in the center of the map. Based on, like, where the map that I'm looking at, it shows me where PMCs can spawn. I think we're in the center of the map. We have a bridge. So theoretically, right now, we are going west. And if we keep going this way, the water treatment with the... Rogues is like legit right ahead of us. That's what this is right here, and they should have mounted guns. And they won't fuck with us so long as we don't fuck with them. In theory. But they'll have like patrols and shit walking around. I am just going to leave them. Oh yeah, there's a dude I think right there. On a mounted gun. Yeah, I'm not gonna... I don't wanna actually, like, point my weapons at him or anything. Oh, shit. I bet that's a minefield. I don't know if this is... I need to figure out if this is a minefield sign. I assume that that is a minefield sign. I'm not gonna go over there. Like, that's gotta be a minefield. Okay, so... It is known. So yeah, like I said, like, yeah, you can see there's a dude up there. They'll leave us alone, and I guess they'll actually tell us to, like, fuck off if we get... Like, they'll give us warnings. They're not just gonna immediately open up on us if I get near them. I think it's different if you're a scav. Like, if you're a scav, they'll just fucking kill you. Because apparently the rogue faction is like ex-USEC guys, so they're ex-PMC. And also if you're a bear, I believe that they will kill you. So you're just fucked if you are not USEC, essentially. But yeah, I'm gonna leave them be. We're just gonna kind of walk along here. And see what's what. I'm curious if we can bring scavs, like AI scavs, over here to them. And they'll just blast the shit out of them and kill them for me. Could be fun. So according to the map, so there's a scav extract over here, apparently. But more importantly, assuming I don't get ganked, yes, there's a hidden cache right here. I just want some goodies. Keeping that, and a power band. What is this, like a, power supply? Yeah. These are like anchors. Plug them into your USB and then use it to charge your cell phone when the power is dead. Been there before. Okay, so theoretically, there should be a road on my right. Yes, okay. So, if we follow this road, it'll actually take us to the checkpoint, the northern... Give me the exfil, please. The northern checkpoint, which actually isn't on there, that worries me. That's the PMC extract, though. So we'll just kinda head that way and... pray that nobody gets pissed at me or tries to murder me. Dark... wolves, grues, whatever. There's another area back here too, because like I think this is also, this might also be the water treatment plant. Again, I'm gonna just give them a wide berth. But so this hangs. Okay, so there's another structure like over here. It looks like a train yard. I can't tell, and that says that that's where the train comes in, the armored train, which I assume that that's like the train on. God, what map is it? Interchange? There's the one map where a train comes in like 15 or 20 minutes in and it just turns into like a huge like fucking bloodbath. So that could be a thing. Yeah, there's like minefields and shit and I don't want to deal with that. I just got a thing. What is that? What did I just get? I have no idea what's going on. I might have just gotten a skill bonus or something. I should go into like my... I shouldn't say go into my old save. But I should get like my survived raids numbers and stuff and bring that over too. Of course, it's probably not fair to do that because I'm bad, but you know. And I didn't bring over my gun mastery stats because there's just too many of them. Just skills. Yeah, I don't know. We had that icon in the upper corner. Unless it's under health, maybe? Yes. Oh, okay. We are fatigued. What? What is that? Because I'm sprinting around? I'm daring to move at a pace that is not snail-like? You fuckers. Because this game's not freaking shitty enough. Okay. So according to the map, yeah, it might not be here. There's like loot that can spawn, like just laying on the ground out here somewhere. But it's kind of hard to tell where that would be. Especially since it's dark out. Yeah, we should have an extract like right over here. Like this fence should lead us to an extract. Yes, no? Yes, no? Game. Oh no, it's in this nice little killing field here where they could pop scavs to wait. Aw, oh, that's mean. What is this? Blessed Freedom? No. Okay, so we do not have the northern checkpoint this time, apparently. So what do we have available to us? Alright, road to the military base costs 5,000 rubles, so that's no-go. We could take the armored train, it's not here, and also it's probably going to be a bad time TM copyright trademark. Path to shoreline is northeast. Southern road... Come on. Southern road's on, like, literally the opposite side of the map. So, realistically, our best bet for getting out of here is this path to shoreline. That's the shortest path, anyways. All of these are going to be bad, essentially. I should have brought rubles. Or actual equipment. I don't know. We'll poke around. I fully expect to die again. I expect to die a lot in this area, honestly. Until we get a good bearing on, like, the layout and stuff. Because, like, right now, we have no idea where bots spawn. We have no idea where, like, easy quick runs for loot are. We don't know building layouts. It's just a bad time. So yeah, we'll just use that as a learning experience, I suppose. Because I mean, we can always reset our account if need be. What's this? Examine. Some ammo. What kind of ammo? BT. 545, alright. I mean, it can just sit there and we'll vendor it at some point, I'm sure. And I don't get picked off. I wish this game had mantling in it so you could like pull yourself up onto like ledges and shit. It would probably be a little too much, I think. Cause you get people just hiding in the shittiest fucking places. But still, fun to think about as I get fucking stuck in the terrain. Feels like they nerfed loot on jackets. It used to like always feel like jackets had something in them, whether it was just like keys or, you know, random miscellaneous crappery, and now they don't. And it makes me sad. And I see these fucking blue pallets over there. I'm like, I should dig at that with a shovel to get concrete or gravel. And then I remember I'm not playing 7 Days to Die anymore. Feel as though I should do another Let's Dig Around series on that, too. That game is pretty fun. It's in good shape now, I think. Like, better shape than it was, which I didn't think it was in bad shape in the first place. The problem, though, like, I don't necessarily like to toot my own horn too often. It feels like the game's easier than it used to be, like, once you kind of get established. The last time I played it, it was right after, like, the most recent big update, and I went, like, I had, like, maybe 45 or 50 hours of playtime, and I played it hardcore. I didn't die in that entire time. And there were, like, maybe a couple close calls, but the majority of the time I was in, like, no real danger. So my thinking is that, like, that kind of thing would, at this point, unless I, like, really just blew the difficulty up, maybe be, like, a little uninteresting to watch. Whoa. I saw that dude. I saw him. Oh, and down we go. Did he headshot us? I bet he headshot us, because we didn't get hit. He shot at us, like, 3 times. First couple missed. I saw him, but no cover. And with a hand cannon, we're not going to win that fight. Yeah, oh no, he got me in the torso. Just, 7.62 ammo. Oh no, he did hit me twice. Okay. But he only got me once. Sure. Fair. Alright. Maybe we should try the Mosin. I don't know. Or we could try our sneaky boy and get a factory run in. Which I think is what we will do. Because holy shit, I need money. We're hurting so bad for funds. Like, we've got 700,000, which is not a small amount of cash, but, I mean, it is a small amount of cash, but, like, with regards to my general loadout that I run with, it's not bad. But damn, like, it's never enough. I could have, like, infinite money, and I'd still be like, I don't want to use my good stuff. Oh, does this have a, this looks like it has a flashlight. It does, a flashlight, nice. Okay. 3 reloads, a grenade, 2 grenades, that's a pop grenade, just get rid of that. Alright, so this actually isn't a bad start. Okay, where are we? I guess per usual it's spawning us on the opposite side of the map that I want to be on. This might get me... Yeah, okay, we're good. Alright. Here's freedom. I'm just gonna pop the door. Okay. The Schwartz be with you? I don't know what you said, dude. Ah, I was gonna say it would be nice if that body armor spawned in here, and look at fucking that. I thought that used to spawn on top of them, not on the floor. Oh no, I'm thinking about the body armor upstairs. Because there's that body armor that spawns up in the, like, offices that I'm currently going to probably have to violence my way to. Oh, where these guys are. Close the fucking door. Oh, I bet you they're down in the bathrooms down there, shooting the shit out of each other. That's usually where the violence happens. Like, in great numbers. Close the door. Oh, that's right, I forgot we've got the window exit. Shit. So good. Don't fucking do it. I don't want to leave just yet. I want to have a chance to get greedy first and lose it all, because otherwise it's no fun. And rounds are easy. Oh, we're using buckshot. Theoretically, ooh, and a key. Federal State Reserve Agency Base Guard Barracks. Book, your rub, diary, and some more rubles. Sure. I'm actually not too enamored with these croutons, but whatever. Nope, we're not leaving yet. Do I want to? I hate that you have to search these things individually. It takes so long. It's just painful. No, I'm not gonna. No. God damn it. Oh, I'm not even mad. I deserve that. I got greedy. Son of a bitch. Alright, well, I think on that note, I'm going to go ahead and call this here. And I will see you guys next time, where we're probably going to go puttering about in the lighthouse some more with our basic loadout. We might give the Mosin a run. I know some people swear by it. I don't know, we'll see. Like I said, though, I am calling SOS for usual, folks. Thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time, where in survival continues. Until then...